Yeah, we're out here doing this studio quality. I ain't got on no wallabies, just sandals. This is about enough for me to handle moving on up. Gotta improve in everything I do. Can't do it alone, gotta have a crew. So, what I'm gonna talk about today is understanding how to connect with the people you're trying to help, people you want to provide value to. Like, I'm not trying to spin this like it's some business thing, right? Like, you don't even need a business to help people. You don't even need a business to provide value. All you need is an idea. All you need is that intention. So the things I'm about to mention, I'm gonna help you with this, help you on this path. So really, one of the main things, whether you want to call it a customer, whether you want to call it a prospect, whatever you want to call it, I think the best term to call it would just be people, right? You want to help people, you want to provide value to people. So with that being said, the main thing you want to do is make sure that the people you're helping feel like they're understood, right? Like, people want to feel understood. Like, a person who feels like you understand their problem is much more likely to want to work with you, much more likely to want to help you, much more likely to provide value to you back in return, whether it's money, whether it's knowledge, whatever it is. But either way, what I found is in my life, the more value I provide to people, the more value that comes back to me. So yeah, just how do you make people feel better understood, right? There's a lot of different ways to do that. Really, you want to understand these people. You want to understand your customers. You want to be able to really like feel their pain. Like, what is it? What problem are you solving? Like, what pain does your customer, what pain do people have that you've already solved for yourself that you can help other people solve, right? So yeah, when you have like people that you're trying to help, I've said this before, what you want to do is create like a customer. A lot of times they call it an avatar. Basically, get to know who your customers are. Make a list of things they all have in common. Their goals, their dreams. Specifically, what pain are they trying to get rid of? So once you understand this, it's so much easier to connect with them, right? So how do you find out their pain? You just need to really like talk to people, right? Just like if you were testing a product, right? Let's say you had some kind of like new sports drink, right? What would you do? You would take it out, maybe a crowded place, go crowded place in public, set up a table, do like ABC split testing, put like take the label off the drink, put like your new drink here. Put maybe some like popular sports drink already here and another popular brand right here, right? Have them try all three. Ask them which ones they like the best. Take notes. See which one. By the end of the day, you talk to 100 people, you're going to get a lot of good information. Well, in this case, if you're trying to provide value to people with like a non-physical product, with like information, was something that you could consider yourself an expert at because you've already solved your own problems with it. You want to talk to people and say like, "Hey, what is your biggest fear? Like, what is your biggest frustration in what you're doing? Like, what's causing you the most pain, right?" Because a lot of times people are really embarrassed to admit it to other people, but they're even more embarrassed to admit these things to themselves. So if you understand this, that gives you an advantage, basically, right? Because a lot of times people might be afraid to talk about something, but you've already been there, so you know. So you can like intuitively realize certain things that people are kind of not trying to admit, things that people are kind of trying to leave out of the picture. And when you see that, that's like gold right there. That's what you want to learn. That's what you want to take notes down. So basically, once you get this, right, you can take it to the next step, which is like, what is this person? What is the mental conversation that they're having in their own head? Like, what kind of ways are they thinking about these problems, right? Like, oh, I want to do this, but I can't because of this. And if I only had this, then I'd be able to finally do this. Well, you know that for the most part, that's all bullshit, right? Because you've already solved your own problem. You know that these are basically like excuses that people use to really stop themselves from like digging deep, going in to like really do the work that they need to do to make a change. So this is where you come in. This is where you can help people, right? This is really thought of like irrational thoughts, right? Because at the end of the day, you know that these things that your customer, your prospect, the people you're trying to help, you know that these conversations that they're having in their mind that's really blocking them from making these improvements or these breakthroughs, you know that it's irrational. However, the people you're talking to don't understand that this is irrational. To them, this is like a fact, right? So what you need to do is you need to find a way to get through to them that this is irrational. Now, there's a lot of different ways to do this. I think that'd be another, good topic for another video, just going on like how to break down different ways to like, show people that the blocks they have, the mental limitations that they have are all irrational, right? So, that being said, when you're, trying to connect with your customers, when you're communicating with your customers, when you're trying to make them feel like they're understood, what is their reality? Like, what do they consider to be their reality on a daily basis? And then go through and figure yourself, like, what actually parts of their reality are actually real and what parts are irrational. So, the more information you get, the better, because then you can really like brush up, fine-tune the actual avatar, the description of your customers. And over time, this is going to help you with like every area of your business, even if you don't have a business. Like my first business, actually, I didn't even register an LLC. I didn't even register a business. I just started doing it, right? I mean, you can still file taxes as a business without having an LLC. Like a lot of people I've talked to, that's even a limiting belief for them. That's even an irrational thing. It's like, well, I don't know how to start a business, so I can't help people. I can't provide value to people. Well, that's even kind of what I'm doing right now. I'm trying to show people, like, it's so easy. Like, it's so much easier to go out, do something you enjoy doing, do something you know that you consider yourself an expert at, that you can help people, than to actually like go work at a job, get up, go to your job every day, sit through traffic, all that stuff. Plus, you'll get paid a lot more. Trust me, like, you will make so much more money. You will get so much more value back in return by solving people's problems than by, doing some like repetitive task for a boss so that, the owner of the company can get their dreams fulfilled. Like, you want to focus on your own dreams. You want to help other people. Another important thing is like, don't treat people like a customer. Don't treat people like the normal, like, hi, how can I help you today? Like, all that kind of nonsense, whatever. Like, talk to these people like they're your friends, right? Like, don't ever treat someone like they're below you because they have a certain problem. Like, treat every single person that you want to help, every single person you provide value to, like it's one of your friends. When a person feels like, they're a friend to you, they feel more understood. And all this is tying together. The more a person is feeling understood, the more they're going to be open to your suggestions that their limiting beliefs and their irrational thoughts are not helping them. And this is how you can really help people with breakthroughs. This is where you're going to get the most value back in return. And as always, don't focus on the value that you want. Like, go into this just with the intention of like, what can I do? Even if you already have a job, you don't have to quit your job. Like, what can I do to help people on the side? Like, how can I provide value to people? And the second that you're thinking about like, what can I do to help people so I can get this new car or this new house? Like, you've already failed. Like, that's not what you want to do. Like, you need to just be focused on how can I provide more and more value? That's all you should focus on. Don't think of what you're going to get in return, nothing like that. Just know that if you help people, you will get compensated in return, right? So yeah, you know, show interest in your customers, your prospects, build connections with them. And this even goes on to when you're actually like, you know, building your product, when you're building whatever, you know, whether it's like a physical product, whether it's like an information product, help educate your customers on how you created that product, right? And by doing this, you want to really include your own story, right? Like, what led you to become an expert at what you're doing so that you understood how to create this product in the first place? And you can, you know, basically educate each step of the way of the creation of this product. And that's really, I feel like another thing to that is that's really like the future of marketing, right? Advertising, right? So you see advertising today, a lot of these, you know, bigger companies, especially like more of the commercials on TV, stuff like that. The part I think they get the best is that they're, you know, they're conveying a feeling that you're trying to have like a customer have, like whether it's like a soda, like a person would feel refreshed, food, people would feel like satisfied. So basically, you know, you're just trying to educate these people on the building of the product, right? So this is like your marketing, right? So when you're putting out like emails or videos and you're showing people how you created this product, that also helps to help people differentiate that you're not a company that's trying to really sell them something. You're a person that's trying to provide value to them and help them. So one more point I really want to make with this is be careful on, you know, coming off as though you're trying to tell people what to do, right? Like, it's better than telling people, giving orders. Like, people don't respond to that so well, right? What people respond better to is suggestions, presenting them with information that they can use. So with that being said, when you do kind of like paint this picture of suggestions, think about it like you're kind of like putting out the pieces to a puzzle. Only you want your customer, you want the people you're trying to provide value to put this together on their own. Like, just give them the clues, right? Because if you try to tell someone what to do, I can tell you in most cases, and I used to be like this myself, like, can't nobody tell me nothing, right? Like, man, there's so many people like that out there. And it's so frustrating to deal with these people because you can't tell them anything, right? You can't tell them what to do. And I mean, that's, you know, I'm not trying to say that's like a bad thing. It's just somebody that's not conscious enough to realize that, you know, they can make a lot more progress if they do, you know, make improvements in their life, stuff like that. But anyways, yeah, you just need to basically let people come to this conclusion already. And that all ties into, you know, like when you're finding, you know, when you're doing your marketing, have this in mind, because you want people to work with you that have found you because they're actively trying to solve their problem, right? It's not like you're going out there and saying like, hey, you know, did you guys know that, you know, most of you have this problem and you didn't even know it? Well, you know, I'll help you fix it. Like, no, people aren't trying to hear that they have problems. Like, you don't want to tell people like, yeah, you got a problem. No, you want to find people that are already trying to solve their problem, which is why, you know, it's important to do like Facebook ads, Google ads, because people, when they have a problem, what do? They go onto Google, they search for it. They're on Facebook, you know, that's where most people are. The only difference is like Google is more like people are searching for stuff. However, Facebook, you can get way more specific on the people that you're targeting. So the more information you have on the people you're trying to help, the better you are reaching and finding these people.